It's a Ten Commandment controversy, and new tonight, the rally over a religious monument and what supporters are doing to save it. That monument has been a hot topic in the Connellsville community.
Yeah, one group wants it out. Tonight, others struggle with ideas to save it, maybe move it. Ashley Hardway, live there tonight. Ash.
Yeah, Wendy and Mike, this rally started at 5 o'clock. It's over now, but there are still people around, and this is what they're fighting to keep. Right behind me, you can see a monument of the Ten Commandments. It is unveiled now, but it has been covered ever since a group in Washington, D.C. demanded its removal. And while there was a rally here to save it, the law is clear. It has to go.
Today, I think it's tragic what is happening in our country.
They came out in dozens to support their school district, to support their God.
It's God's principles, and I believe that God should be in school with our children. And if you don't believe that way, I respect yours, your right, your opinion. Please respect mine.
Days after a group in Washington, D.C. demanded the Ten Commandments on Connellsville Junior High East property be removed as required by the separation of church and state, supporters rallied in front of the monument, begging school leaders to fight it. A Uniontown pastor led the rally, citing a letter from the 1940s from President Franklin D. Roosevelt.
If the word of God is good enough for our soldiers and can vanify the President of the United States, it should be good enough for our students as they walk by. Amen?
Amen. Amen.